What's going on, guys? This is Riggs from Clashing FFS, bringing you not only a brand new video, but a brand new attack strategy that is just now hitting the war scene. I'll give you guys a quick background of what this war is. This is the Forbidden versus Dark Looters Z CWO Week 4 matchup. And there's an attack strategy going on right now that is taking the war community by storm. This is a Town Hall 10 attack strategy working on all different types of bases. Forbidden right now, you guys, completely killing it. We have 11 10v10s already, and three of them in this war have come using the attack strategy that people are calling the Falcon. So we're going to go ahead and check out each one of those attacks. Like you guys have probably seen in the other videos, when I do an attack strategy video, I don't like doing just one. Just so you guys can really understand and really see the attack and you know what exactly is going on. We're going to start right here on number 24, where we have Cherry. He's going to be coming in here. And this is the attack strategy. I'll go ahead and pause it real quick for those of you that have not seen it. Again, we have seen it a few times, but it seems just in the last 48 hours, it has really been a popular attack strategy in a lot of clans. So, like many attack strategies, things can change. One thing that's always going to be there is the Queen Walk. You're always going to be bringing those four healers for the Queen Walk. Anywhere from 13 to 17 Valkyries, anywhere from 4 to 6 Bowlers. You always have your heroes. As far as the elixir spells, those pretty much stay the same, bringing 3 rage and 2 heal. Some are using skeleton spells to distract the IT. Some people are bringing double poison. On this one, Cherry's going to be bringing 8 balloons. I've seen it used with balloons and bringing a haste along. Some people bringing a hog. But the main thing is that big push with the Valkyries and the bowlers, and in your clan castle, you have max bowlers. So the main thing that can vary is what some of your back-end troops are going to be, whether it's going to be hogs or loons. We'll go ahead and watch this attack, and it's a very, is it called the Falcon? I want to say it's called the Falcon. I mean, there's kind of a little rhyming there. But I think it's because it just rips through the base so fast. Just wait till you guys see it. So as the Queen Walk's going, it's all about setting the funnel. So one side, you're setting the funnel with that Queen Walk. The other side, you can use a baby dragon. On this one, Cherry's dropping down a couple loons on that mortar and just using a wizard and a bowler for a funnel. So that is going to have to, I mean, that's just going to come down to how the base is designed and the base is set up. You're just going to have to determine how you're going to set the funnel on the other side, because you don't want the Valkyries, the King, the bowlers to walk. You want them going straight into the base. So as you see, clearly set the funnel on both sides. The Valks are going to beat through the wall. There's absolutely no wall breakers. There's no jumps on this attack. And the reason why some people are saying this attack strategy is even more powerful or even more reliable than something like Bitch is because on a Bitch attack, 2 of your elixir spells, 2 out of the 5 are just with jump spells. On this attack, you don't. It's rages and heals. The Valks, I mean, basically under rage, one shot, a max wall at Town Hall 10. Just look at this base. Look at these Valks. They beat through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 layers of walls, and there goes a couple more loons down there, pretty much swagging the scaly spell. And check this out. Both hero abilities too, you guys. So you want to talk about a strong attack strategy, please give this one a try. This, I guarantee you, this is not just like a one-hit wonder type of attack strategy. I mean, out of the 11 10v10s, 3 of them have been using this attack strategy. Swag both hero abilities. Unbelievable. Huge shout out to Cherry on that one. Now we'll go ahead and check out the next one. We'll jump up here. Forbidden, I'm telling you guys, Forbidden is freaking killing it. All right, this is going to be Oblivio Star. And like I said, I'll go ahead and pause it real quick before we start. Queen's over there at 9 o'clock. So like I said, there can be a couple different variations. Like in the other one, we didn't see any baby drags. This one has two baby drags. There's no balloons, but there's three hogs. So there are going to be a couple accessories that can change. But the main thing is those CC bowlers and those and that huge group of Valkyries pushing all the way through the base. Okay, so we'll go ahead and hit play again. So Oblivious Star is going to be starting as Queen over here on the far left-hand side. And again, guys, it's all going to be about the funnel. You cannot have that main pack of Valkyries walk on this attack. It will be completely devastating. But you get all those Valkyries in the core, plus with the bowler bounces. And like I said, with Bitch, you only have, you have two Rage and one Heal traditionally. Two Rage, one Heal. And again, the other two spells are Jump. This one, you have two Heal as opposed to just one, and you have three Rage as opposed to just two. So yeah, I mean, it's absolutely incredible. So we had a baby dragon that was over there on the town hall. Here's a baby dragon up there at 1 o'clock, followed by a couple of wizards just trying to set that flank and making sure that that storage goes down. Once that storage goes down, the funnel is pretty much set. He's gonna be entering in right here at 12 o'clock. And look at the baby dragon still up, gonna even get that archer tower. So raging, that's usually what you do. You're gonna rage all your troops right through. As you start the attack, you're gonna follow that up with a heal spell pretty much in the core. Poison for the CC. It doesn't even really matter what the CC is, whether it's a hound, whether it's damage, the CC does not matter. Healers ended up peeling off of the queen and they started healing up some of the bowlers. And check this out, guys, the Valkyries just ripped through the wall. The bowlers push right behind them. And as the defenses are distracted, he went ahead and dropped a couple hogs right around there. And look at those hogs are still up while the bowlers are being tanked that are getting healed by the healers. The heroes in there, these hogs, look, he only brought three hogs to this attack. How many hogs are still up? All three of them, because all the defenses are distracted. Just all kinds of troops. Look at all the redheads running outside the base. They beat through the wall. Look, swagging a rage. I mean, it's just complete madness. This attack, I was even practicing it in FCs. It's so strong right now, and of course, mainly because of the single shot. I mean, the Inferno Towers pretty much do not matter on this attack. Now, go ahead and pause it one more time for you guys. When I'm watching an attack strategy video, or when I make an attack strategy video, a lot of people ask, well, what kind of bases does it work on? It's a very good question. It's not going to work on every single base, although some are saying that this attack strategy can work on every single base. When I was practicing it in FC, I would say open style layouts, it does not work very well because the Valkyries split up too much, the bowlers split up too much, there's too many possibilities where there could be the different giant bombs and your troops splitting. It's very, very difficult to control your troops when it's a very open layout. When these bases are very tightly compact, that's when it works the best. You get more value from the bowler skips, and your Valkyries cut a clean path for all your troops to follow right behind them. Okay, guys, so on this one, we have JFM starting as queen over here on the far right-hand side. And again, on this one, he's bringing five hogs for the back end. And every single one of these attacks, you do have CC bowlers. So right here, just starting over here at 3 o'clock, he wants her queen to walk down. Kind of wants to funnel into that 6 o'clock compartment. Wizard on the gold mine. Right here, JFM kind of falling asleep at the wheel a little bit. We thought he was going to drop his rage on that queen right there, ends up having to pop ability right about now, and right here just waiting for his king to go down. And you can always bring, you can always drop a couple of Valkyries to also set that funnel. So king on the DSF. So right here, he dropped down that wizard just in time. So if that king went over to that dark barracks, he would have walked. But he dropped that wizard down just in time, raging all these troops right into this core, poison down for the CC, for the enemy CC troops. Queen one shot the baby dragon, heal spell right there in the court on this one. He's also going to be bringing a skeleton spell in the troop comp. Another heal inside the core, followed up by another leading rage. And check this out. You got King tanking for the bowlers over here. A couple healers on him. You have Queen right there in the core. That skelly spell on the Inferno Tower. Valk's ripping through. Bowlers falling right behind them. And right about now, you know that it is GG. He's got three more hogs and King ability. And there's literally, I mean, there's just nothing left of this base. And pretty much all three of these attacks, you guys, have been sub 2 minute raids. So, I mean, it's definitely an attack strategy you have got to try. I mean, it's very, very effective on all different types of base setups. Obviously, like I already said earlier, the base styles you pretty much want to use it on is one where it's not very open layout. You want it to be kind of compact to keep the Valkyries so they can cut a nice path for all your troops to follow right behind them. It's very, very strong, guys. Give it a try. Let me know what you think down in the comment section below. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you smack that like button. Subscribe to the channel if you have not already. Bringing you guys yet another brand new Town Hall 10 attack strategy. Hope you enjoyed it. As always, and it's called the Falcon, this is Riggs, Clashing FFS, and I'll see you in the very next video.